You may have heard that your vibe attracts your tribe. And while I do believe that to be true, when it comes to attracting toxic people, it's not always a one-to-one thing. Just because you're attracting toxic people doesn't mean that you're toxic or abusive yourself. So let's get started with the five reasons you are attracting toxic people into your life. Welcome to the Common Ego Community. My name is Christina, and on this channel, we talk about emotional abuse, spirituality, self-development, and more. If those topics interest you, I suggest you subscribe because you're going to find a whole lot of that content here. And if you hit that notification bell, you're going to get a notification every time I post new content. This way, you won't miss a video. So, as we get started, I just want to quickly cover what I mean by toxic people, because that can cover a whole lot of different things and it can be really confusing. And what I'm talking about really here is people who are toxic to you, people who may have proven to be toxic to you in your life. And while it's never your fault that somebody is acting a certain way towards you, everyone's responsible for their own actions, for their own behavior. But the truth is, there are some things we might be doing that are almost acting like smoke signals to the toxic people out there that we might be good targets for their nonsense. Again, their nonsense, their responsibility, not your fault. But if you can repel these people before they even get into your life, that's a good thing. Okay, so the first thing you might be doing to attract toxic people into your life is it might be one that you have guessed already. This one is pretty common, and you can see very easily how it might attract a toxic person. And number one is people pleasing. As a recovering people pleaser myself, I know how dangerous this one can be. At its core, people pleasing is about external validation. It's about placing your own value with someone else, with someone else's approval or disapproval of you. And I like to look at it this way because it kind of helps me put things into perspective. Imagine you were going for ice cream with one of your friends and you got your favorite flavor. That would be mint chocolate chip for me. But you get whatever your favorite flavor is, and your friend is not shy about telling you how they feel about it. That is, to them, that is the worst flavor ever invented, and it tastes like dirt. Does that ice cream start to taste different as soon as your friend said that? Does it magically change? No, the ice cream still has the same value. To you, it's amazing. To the other person, it's not. But it's just ice cream. The ice cream's value does not change. The ice cream's properties do not change. The ice cream tastes the same before and after your friend makes that comment. When you care about somebody else's opinion, and their opinion of you fluctuates, and you're placing your value of yourself in their opinion of you, it can be devastating when they don't agree with what you're doing, or if they're angry with you or disappointed in you. Because at that point, you feel like that is where your value is at. You know, at the beginning of the day, maybe you felt great, and then you found out that this person was angry with you for some reason. And suddenly, you feel terrible about yourself. Not the situation, but you feel terrible about yourself. So, how do toxic people know this? How do they know that you're placing your value in someone else? Well, they may or may not know this, but they can see toxic people can spot a people pleaser from a mile away because these are people who put others first all the time. These are people who don't feel good about themselves unless they're doing for someone else. And unless someone else is approving of what they're doing. But it's easy to see when somebody is going a little bit too far for approval. And that is something that will definitely attract toxic people. Because somebody who's abusive is going to look to exploit whatever they can out of a person. And unfortunately, you can get a whole lot from somebody who's a people pleaser because they will literally give you everything they have in order to make you happy, because that's what gives them value. And if you've encountered a toxic person or an abusive person, you know that you can give everything and it's not enough. So if you want to stop attracting toxic people or worse, keeping toxic people in your life. And if you think you're guilty of this people-pleasing nature, which a lot of us really are, I'd suggest starting by putting your focus there. The goal is to be like the ice cream that does not change. It doesn't care if somebody else likes it or doesn't like it. Its flavor stays the same. So the second way you might be attracting toxic people into your life is by having a savior complex. And I think that when you hear this, a lot of people might not relate to that term. Well, I'm not somebody's savior, but hear me out. Because if you have ever been guilty of going out of your way to try and fix somebody or to try and fix a situation for someone, especially when they didn't ask you to do it, then this applies to you. And it's unfortunate because wanting to help people is such a good and empathetic trait to have. But remember that if somebody is not asking for your help, then you're crossing their boundaries. And somebody who has good personal boundaries is going to see that as an attack. They're going to see instantly that you're overstepping, and they're probably going to be uncomfortable with that. Or if they recognize that they do need help and that you can provide that help, they're going to accept it and take responsibility for it. But somebody who is toxic will never do that. Somebody who's toxic will love for you to take responsibility for their problems and for fixing their problems, even though they know that you can't do that. You can't fix somebody else. Now, a lot of toxic people already know this, but they know as long as you don't know it, as long as you think that you can save them, that they have got you on the hook. That you will continue staying there and continue trying to save them until you have literally nothing else to give. I've heard the example before about somebody drowning. So imagine that toxic person is physically drowning in water and you go there and you try to save them. But what ends up happening is that in the process, they're trying to save themselves and they're pushing you under the water. If they're really drowning, pushing you down isn't going to save them. Eventually, you're both going to be underwater. So the third thing that might be attracting toxic people into your life is perfectionism. And this one's a little tricky because perfectionism sometimes does yield positive results. If you work really hard in school, you'll probably get good grades. If you spend extra hours and you put your all into a project at work, you might get a promotion, you might get a raise, but in one way or another, you'll probably be recognized for your hard work. But perfectionism is also rooted in external validation. When you want everything to be perfect, it's usually because you want some sort of recognition for the perfection. Or it could be that you just can't handle people associating you with something that isn't perfect, something that is subpar. But usually perfectionism is about other people's opinions of you. And whenever you're placing your value in someone else's hands, it is incredibly dangerous. The fourth thing that you might be doing to attract toxic people into your life is oversharing. And this one is interesting. As I was doing research for this video, I came across an article about oversharing. The researchers found that we tend to overshare more as we get older. And I found that to be true for myself too. I never used to share anything. When I was younger, I didn't share any personal details about myself. But as I got older, I started noticing that I was sharing more and more about myself. And most experts agree that we do this when we overshare, when we share too much information about ourselves too fast, or things that are too personal, that we're doing this because we're really craving intimacy. And if you're out there oversharing, you might be sending the message to the wrong people that you crave intimacy so much that you're willing to forget about your personal boundaries in order to get it. And that, again, is very dangerous. So the fifth thing you could be doing to invite a toxic person into your life is bending to avoid conflict. So I'm not just talking about people who don't like conflict, because there are some people who don't like conflict and they will just remove themselves from any conflict situation that they can. And those people aren't necessarily the best target for an abusive person, because the abusive person's going to need you to stick around so they can abuse you. They need a target for their negativity, and if you're not around, then you're not going to be a good target. But somebody who is going to act like everything is okay when it's not, somebody who is going to put up with somebody else's nonsense, somebody who clearly is uncomfortable with something and they're just keeping it to themselves, or maybe saying the opposite, no, no, everything's fine, oh, it's good, everything's good. Unfortunately, that person, who is probably a very beautiful soul, is going to be a great target for somebody who's abusive. Because if they can see you going out of your way to diffuse conflict, even at the expense of your own happiness or your own well-being, then they're going to know that you'll do the same for them. And that means that if that person is in your life, they're going to get away with a whole lot. Really, if you're not comfortable with conflict, they can lie and cheat and steal and be relatively assured that you're not going to say too much about it. And the sad truth is that not everybody out there has our best interests at heart. And the most dangerous thing about these behaviors, about attracting toxic people, is that these behaviors are also behaviors. These are also things that are going to keep that toxic person in your life. So not only is somebody who is toxic or abusive going to see these behaviors, but these are the very things that will keep that person in your life long enough for you to find out that they're toxic. Because the truth is, if you feel like you're attracting toxic people, it's not just that the toxic people are out there, because they're out there. Trust me, they're out there. It's because you've allowed them a place in your life. Because otherwise, if you did not allow them a place in your life, then you wouldn't know that they're toxic. When it gets to the point where you recognize that they're toxic, it almost feels like it's too late. It's not too late. It is never too late. But at that point, you're so energetically and emotionally tied to the person that it becomes difficult to break that tie. So that's why I wanted to put out this video on reasons why you might be attracting toxic people into your life. Their toxic behavior is not your fault, and their behavior is not your responsibility. But again, if there is something any of us can do to keep these people out of our lives, then I think it's worth doing. So if you found this video helpful, please let me know by hitting the like button. If you have any other tips on how to stop attracting toxic people, please do let us all know in the comments below. And if you aren't already subscribed, now's a great time to do that. And I will see you all next time.